Okay, this is the sign for the township of Sutri. It looks like a new town on an old town here in Italy, in Sutri. It looks like we'll be heading over to some of these areas over here. Another shot up here of the churches atop the hill. On the sign there is an English description. There is a combination here of old and new fittings, old fittings. This doorway, a cartouche up here above the door. Various aspects, the town and churches across that side. This doorway has been filled in, or entranceway. Little doors, openings, water perhaps to wick away the water. We'll take a look at the sign over here. Just going down the sign slowly so that the words are captured for those who want to. You can see talk of Mithrin and Christian places of worship, rituals, etc. within here.
We are in Sutri. This is the area of the necropolis, and then we will go to the amphitheatre.
Within here, this is quite impressive up here, the structure. And then there's a great case here of the new building on top of these very ancient structures that head along the side of this wall face. Just having a look through here.
There is a lovely head here.
This drops away. This kind of tracks through. Looks to be, that's possibly very ancient there. And in the case here on this end, there's sort of facial remnants with the possible ram face configuration on the side there.
Dove thing there.
Another shot of that.
Also, I'm gonna take a quick one then, and I'll be out of your way.
No, and then we come around.
And also, we get a chance.
Here is the doorway kind of edifice, and this way, as has been put, the doorway to nowhere, anyway, configuration up there. Down here, we can sit for perspective, the pigeonholes coming up. Simone is suggesting water here, possibly a water channel through here, alcove-like structure here, and remnants of it here as well. Very interesting architecture. The tunnel under, somebody's stored some modern pipes and pipes within it, but that's the tunnel going through. Of course, this possibly goes deeper. Just to take a step back for a moment, as I've been editing this video, I've noticed the orbs within some of the footage. Now, it may be under lighting or without the lighting. And yes, like everyone, I'm aware that the dust can create this effect or other. But I'm also aware that people like, in particular, Peter Maxwell Slattery and people like James Gilliland are picking up rather exceptional things at times. And I would certainly encourage anyone to hang out with these people, as I've seen things I've never seen before, just being in their presence. But let's get back to the fascinating workings in the rock near the town of Sutri in Italy.
Various cavities, a newer wall in here, in a way protecting the ancient wall within here, with all these they're termed, when I say pigeonholes, they're termed that, but they're of course not necessarily pigeonholes, of course. That structure going up. Just a pan around the whole scene. All sorts of little spots, all sorts of odd aspects to the scene. So the tunnel system, the tunnel, one of the researchers here, so this is the tunnel, continuation of this tunnel system, and if I crank it up, it goes through quite a way and around the bend, and you can see some daylight at the other side. So we're looking through about, I can see through about 30 meters or so, and then going this way, the same again, the tunnel system going through, underground tunnel system basically, to back out from where I am. That's the problem with this. It's a little more complicated, but the sound is a better sound. So, to retreat out from where we are, get a bit of perspective, we can come this way. So the tunnel system runs behind here and around where we just were with the video. And then no doubt, of course, further around this way also. We'll have a look at that in a moment. Okay, we were just around here, we've come around here, and looking through this tunnel at this point, maybe the cliff face has changed, but this is the end of the tunnel here. So we'll actually enter the tunnel, and there's a lot of, it could be of course quite a lot deeper, this tunnel. But looking through this tunnel right now, and it goes quite a way through. In total, this portion of it, probably 80 to 100 meters. We are about 100 meters or so further around the cliff face here. And what happened here is that we now have the reappearance of that tunnel going through here. I've moved up a little bit more.
There's so much broken off. I mean, there could have been
a bit of graffiti in here, you could call it. Maybe it is from 1823. So that tunnel just through there, and then going this way, and it keeps on going through. So the tunnel goes through this way, but just for a moment, the markings on the wall just above it here are quite defined. So this is just a bit of a close-up of these markings into the rock. This is looking out of the tunnel. This is looking, go point it back. This is looking back to where we've just come from and where we looked at the markings. Now we do a 180 and around this way, and we can see further progression through this tunnel. Turn the light, come through please. When you come, so Daniel is now coming through that tunnel, through the end of this tunnel. Well, the end as we know it so far. The end of that tunnel that we just exited was just through here. This is the cliff face coming around. That tunnel seemed to go for a few hundred meters at least. Parts of the cliff have come away, but it was probably all intact at one stage. A sign here, further monuments, further excavations, ancient excavations into the wall, doorways, etc. within here. Just a bit of a pan around to get a bit more idea of the area that we're in. Just going in for a look into this one. Whether modified or not, an interesting aspect to it is that you have the archways to the sides, and in this case also. Very interesting. Now, why would I find these archways or alcoves around this room interesting? Well, that's a huge topic, but in brief, if you have a magic ritual and the participants around the outside, you can have the kind of archways of light around those participants. And for example, in this illustration here, it's potentially based on the participants around the outside. Whilst the researching public generally doesn't take into consideration further light, I certainly do.
The left side, it's always the left side is raised.
Because of the way they were holding the...
The archways persist within these monuments, within these alcoves, areas, within here. And then a series down here, they persist under here. A lot of it is filled in now, but you can see the remnants of them within the dark there. And just a slightly different thing happening here with the architecture. Let's see if it happens again within here. Yes, again within here. So we're getting more of the archways around the sides. This region carries on through here. Camera rolling. We're here to look at this stuff for those interested. Within here, you can still see some of the old finishing and remnants of paint that you can see. There's a little bit in here also. You can see that there was once a lot of beauty here, well finished in their time. Coming into this,
and they're smaller than that, bigger than that.
Oh, that's interesting. Almost like a pillow.
It recedes back and around this way and through to the next one. Let's just soak up more of this. In this case here, these cavities in this room. There they go. Various shapes. Bit of structure up here. Little windows at the sides, often the two little windows at the sides. A lot of structure in here. The floor receding, dips into the floor. Here we have the pattern across the top of these regions, and then again here with the line. Interesting here that they dip in this case. Coming up, the whole scene, and you can get some perspective here without myself getting run over. Here in the commune de Sutri, here is some writing about this extensive place. Within here, just for a bit of scale, the tape measure is up the other end, and the width is, it's wider than it is high, but the width here is, well, it's 8 meters to here. It totals about 8.5 meters. The height would be around 6.5, 7 meters. With so many caverns here, some with the entrances partially, you know, with modern bricks there, going up through the trees, looking up a high one tucked up in here. This one goes deep. Another one above, and another one further down here. So they retreat in quite a way with all manner of markings on the, both on the floor, and the back is just about another few meters here. So we're right at the back, and now looking through to the front. I'm heading up there, so
your friends have been here.
Now we're going to go up, and we're told through the zooming up here that this is a
honeycomb.
Beehive.
Absolutely covered in bees. So I mean, I've never seen nice an exposed beehive.
So much no.
Yeah, it's huge. Okay, so coming through here, you have these cutouts, and up here is the beehive, rather large beehive, and to set the scene, this hewn out road coming around here, massive. It's muddy at the base. You can see the treatment at the lower levels.
The best hypothesis of who built that just emerged a few seconds ago from Simone. It was pigeons. The Etruscans were all pigeons. Do you see the peck marks on the walls? It's all pigeon work. No human would be crazy to dig a street that much high, you know, with primitive tools. And we see the arches at the ground level, so this is only the tip. It was all pigeons.
Picking pigeons.
Yeah.
Thank you, Simone. Thank you, thank you. So, picking pigeons have made this area through here. Further with the walls, you can see the various indentations high up in the walls also. So these are ancient pathways. Here you can see a dip going down, suggestive that this goes deeper, but there's a lot of mud in it now. Sorry, that's me. And again here, this whole section has fallen in. Very ancient roadway. It goes around and continues. Worked areas, it looks like. Continue up through the bush. Up. Just a bit of a close coming around from the roadway, coming into this area here. Various plasters, intriguingly, up in the center. There is remnant, but where this was from, who knows, but it's lotus-like in the center. And also in this alcove too. And there is actually some red paint up there, and remnants with that red paint outline that we have seen prior around Italy at the Via Amarina. There is further detail up in here. Now, whether this was done at a later date by the Romans, it probably was. The artistry up in the centre is not that great. Who knows when that was done? Okay, so within much of this video, we would be looking at what are understood to be Etruscan sites. Now, who knows how far back in time these really go, but then you would have the Roman period that's perhaps combined, but then after that, and the Romans have perhaps fitted places out. Now, we're about to go into the Madonna del Parto, that goes by other names, but within there, it's a completely cut into the rock, the tufa, the soft tufa volcanic rock. And now this temple, interestingly enough, would have perhaps been dedicated at one stage to the god Mithra and then transformed, so from the sort of Mithra cult into the Christian cult with Madonna in there and child, Mary and child, if you will. So you'll see that. And there is perhaps the Archangel Michael on the ceiling also, and reference to the zodiac there, of course. So we'll have a quick look inside. We now return to this spot here and go through this doorway that has now been opened. Getting the plaques. Beneath the mage here are the concentric circles at the base of the feet with the staff. And in this case, kind of a leafy emanation from that staff going up. The veil in here, with this, around mainly the central figure at the back, although there are veils to the sides. This is the triptych of three with the mother and child in the center. Oh, yeah, I'm not. The font right here. This is extensive going through.
No problem. No, it's okay. Thank you, though.
Or around the head. This mural on the ceiling, at the top you have Leo here, one of the fixed signs of the zodiac, the winged lion in this case. There would no doubt be the winged bull, the man, and the eagle here also, but it would have been decayed away. On the ceiling, the halo. Very ancient, and the swirl, interesting swirl patterns in there with the kind of orbs in the swirl pattern also. Close by in the area of Sutri, you have this amphitheatre carved out of the same tufa rock basically. And the Romans are said to have built this. Now, it was uncovered in the 19th century.
and apparently it's decaying away quite fast. It can seat around 9,000 people apparently. Here is a profile of one of the sides you can see, and we'll have a look around it, but you can see the sort of tunnelway there. And yeah, so much rock, not only the rock carved from within, but around the sides perhaps also. This amphitheatre is said to date back to the 2nd century BC, although who knows, it may be older than that. So within the amphitheatre here, here's one of the main entrances, and here is a bit of a pan around with obviously a newer entrance being put over in this direction here, and the walls go way up and then back to that doorway. So around this amphitheatre you have these tunnelways heading through, and this would apply through here as well, with again these tunnelways heading through. And in this case, up. This amphitheatre looks to be hewn out of one big area of rock. It's not single blocks. And it has that tunnel system within it and within the structure. To get to where we are now, there's the recess down, tunnel system down this way. Personally, I find these sites intriguing and amazing in many ways. I put a lot of effort into these videos, so I certainly hope you enjoyed the video. Bye for now.